Good morning students, I welcome you all for the Sheba group of schools online class. So now we are in the fourth unit. So already we have seen the prose, now we are in the poem. So this poem is Ulysses, written by Alfred Tennyson. So Ulysses is a god of travel. So he is a traveler, he has got an experience of traveling to places and exploring new things. So on the previous lesson also we saw how the mountaineering experience of a person. Now we are going to see, this is, he travels by sea. So he used to travel by sea and he has writing his own, whatever he is thinking he is given in this poem. And he has given his own name here. Usually the poets, usually the gods, they don't give the name, but here the poet gives Ulysses his name. And now we are going to see about Alfred Tennyson, the poet of this poem, who has written, and it is like a story, the life, what all happened in the life of Ulysses, he is explaining us in this poem. So Alfred Tennyson, first born Tennyson, 6th August 1809 to 6th October 1892. So he is a very good, it is a British poet. He was the poet laureate. Laureate means the person who works in the king's court as the court poet. So Great Britain and Ireland during much of Queen Victoria's period. And remained one of the most popular British poets. So he is a very good English poet. So Tennyson excelled at penning short lyrics such as Break, Break, Break. He has written a short song. Lyric is a song, words which is written by him. The Charge of the Light Brigade. Then Tears, Idle Tears. And Crossing the Bar. He wrote verses on classical mythology such as Ulysses. Ulysses is a mythology, means writing about a person, a story which happened in it, and it has got some meaning also in it. So, Idylls, the king of tenors. Then Tennyson used to use of the musical qualities of the words. So usually the poets, they use very good words at the end. Emphasizing is rhythm and meaning is sensitive. That it should be a rhythm at the end of the word and also it should be a meaningful and sensitive. So here they are going to the poem now on page number 127. Open your book when you are going to the lesson, you have to read it once. The whole thing you have to read it and then only you will be able to understand the lesson or the poem. So introduction is given here. The poet Ulysses is a dramatic monologic, means a person, single person speaking about himself, that contains 70 lines of a blank verses. So it is like a story. Ulysses, the king of a Ithaca. Ithaca is in a place. So gather his men. So while they're traveling on a voyage or a journey in a ship, they used to have some warriors. So they'll be going on to fight. So usually in the olden days, they used to go only by ship. Naval flights are there. Ulysses has grown old, have experienced many adventures at the Battle of Troy. So when they go to a place called Troy, they fight there a battle, they win, and they come back. After returning to Ithaca, he desires to embark upon his next journey. So he is planning to go for the next one, but is in inquisitive spirit. He had got a good spirit of traveling, but he has become old, forward more and more such. The poem can be divided into three parts. First is the thirst of adventure. When you are going to attain something, you must have a dedication and thirst for that thing what you are going to attain. Next is which does not allow Ulysses. So although he has become very old, it just didn't stop. There are people, those work. Nowadays you can see people, they work for their end of the life. At their old age also they are working for themselves. So the next one is Ulysses handing over the responsibility to his son Telemachus. So when he becomes old, what happened? He gives his power to his son to rule that country, Ithacas. Then with total confidence, so he is a well-abilitated person, his son, Telemachus. So what happened? He gives that. Third part is Ulysses, Callan call off to say, so now again he wants to travel with his old friends. And so what happened? He is calling them to go for an adventure. So this shows that being old also he is very much interested and he want to go on adventure. So here it goes, that's a very big poem, I am not able to go. So I will give you the important things about Ulysses. First part I told you. So he says that I am an idle king. So now I become old, what happened? So people made me idle to stay at home. So, and still heard that from the barren cage. So my wife also, I am staying with my wife and my son, she has also become old now. So what happened? So I am not able to, so I am now inside my house, idle due to my old age. That what, so what I am doing is, simply I eat good food, sleep, and then I take rest. So, but my aim is always having a plan to go on adventure. That loved me. So now when I was on the shore, I was alone there with all my soldiers and other person. I was so happy to explore. So my life was like that. But what happened is, I have seen many kings, many cities, many governments. So many climates, which is bad climate and also good. Life is like that. We always cannot travel our life with all good and flourishing and precious things going on. There will be some faults in our life also. So you should not take it in a wrong way or put it in with yourself. So here what happened, he says that. So then he explains about the victory on Troy, where he got through that. Then what happened, he is coming through. So now he is staying at home. So what he says is, the only thing with what I have with me is my life. I am alive and the breath which I am breathing. So what happened? So I have been put up in that situation. But my son, this is my son, my own Telemachus. But my son now has taken the power. Now he has been put, but he is a very brave man. So, and he also has a very good experience. So his mind is very different. There, if there is any stiff man there, what happened? He can make him a soft person. So that is very important. So always being stiff and being very arrogant is not good. So what happened? We have to change our attitude and you have to soften yourself and you have to mingle with him. So he has got that bite of thing. So in offices of remnants and pay, so it goes on like that. So he talks about the marine travel. What happened? So free heart. So he talks about his son. He's a free-hearted man and a free forehead. So he doesn't take anything much more in his thoughts. So old age hath honored and is toiled. So now what happened? Now I am a old age. So I think about my friends, not a unbecoming men and good. So we have fought against God also. He talks about the nature, where while they are travelling, they have to see all types of storms, then lightning and other the things which happen in the sea. So we have travelled and we have also fought against the gods. The long days, so they have to travel for a long days in their loneliness. Only the slow moon climbs up. So how they find out the direction is by the moon and the morning and the night time. What happened? The moon and the sun is their clock for them. So he talks like that. Then after all the western starts until I. So what happened is, until I die, I won't leave my adventure. I'll be going for, then I will meet my friends. Like I've got my old friends who has traveled with me with my happy isles. Happy British Isles is a different types of small islands. So if you go to Britain, which is got as British Isles, where they have got many types of islands and it is a beautiful coral sea. And a great Achilles. Achilles is his friend, whom we know. So what he says is, so I want to travel with my old friends. But what happened is, he has also become very old, like me. So although he is old, but he has got a strong thoughts, and he can come with me. But I cannot do that. So I am getting older and older. But my thought is, one day or other, I have to again go on the sea and take some adventure. So though much is taken, much abides, and though. So what he talks about himself, that my mind is good and my body is also good, but the age which has come to me, the old age, which makes me to think. So we are not now that strength which in old days. So what when I was very young, I was a very strength man and a very brave man. I can face everything. But now what happened is, I have become old nowadays. So moving earth and heaven. So what happened? There is no destination for us. So because everything is at the back. So where we are being going forward to the heaven in which we are. So it talks about the eternal life. So traveling is only for a certain period we can travel our life in this world. So after that we will be living another type of life. So what happened is, he talks about that. So there is earth and heaven. So in the earth we have to spend certain days, and after that we have to leave this earth and we have to go and stay in the heaven, where there is God is there for us, waiting for us. And yes, we have got a thought that we have got a good building there, built by God for us to go and dwell there. Not like this. This is a temporary place, but the heaven where we are going to live with God is a permanent place. So he talks about that. So I have lent a life here in this earth, going all around. So I have got another life also, which is in heaven, in which we are. So we means all our people, those who left us. So they are all living there. So I am also, when I get older, when I leave this earth, I will be meeting them there in the heaven. Here, our equal temper of heroic. So whoever who was with me, with an heroic heart, the heart of being heroes, heroism, made it by time and fate. So what happened by the time? So becoming old is a passing of time. So when the time passes, the oldness or the weakness of a person comes. And then it may be the fate also. So what happened? We cannot do our things by ourselves. We'll be having all type of knowledge, experience, everything we'll be having. But what happened? But strong in will. The thing is very, very important. As you grow older and older, so you have to honor your parents, your mother and father, who's getting old. So you have to take care of them. You have to feed them. So wherever they go, you have to protect them. So here also, because they will be having a will strong. They will be saying, okay, I will go and come. So in my early age, I have gone every places. But now when they are becoming old, what happens is, it is the responsibility of the children to look after our old parents and whoever is old. So when you pass through any old person, what happens is, you help them. So you try to help them and you pity at them. And whatever you do, what happens? They will be talking all about the old things which they lived and they flourished way. But still, so they are in strive to seek, to find and not to yield. So we can go, we can live a life where we can go around this world by doing an adventures and other things. But we don't know what will happen to us, because our age is, our days are being going to the end. So my dear children, keep this in your mind. So your laces, everybody will become old. So treat the old person with your avidity and help them. Whenever they need it, you help your parents. And don't think they can do everything for you. They will do. They have got the will. But their health and their weakness will stop them. So at that time what happened? As children, what you have to do is, you had to support them and you had to bring them up and you must give them good fair name and fame for them. So keep this in mind, dear students. So this poem is like that. So everybody is, one day we are going to become old, but it's a time for us to take care of old people. So this poem is like that. So children are gift of God given to our parents for them to guide them, to safeguard them, to protect them in their old age. So keep this in mind, and this poem is talking about that. So children are very important. So thank you students for being with me, and God bless you, and go through your days, learn your lessons well and prepare well for your examination. Thank you. God bless you.